get into the menu more or less. I don't think I have the menu for Zen, because literally you just start playing. If you want the menu, you push select, up pops a thing, and then you can start going into your options if you want to go a little bit farther. It winds up basically being exactly like what the FX2 experience is on that front, with getting into your options. But for the most part, Zen just goes, oh, you're here? Let's play.
Let's play. You don't need to set up anything. Everything is just laid out ready for you to go.
It just goes. So, like I said, let's see what I have here next on my video. Ah, yes. The Zaccaria experience. I'm going to pause this real quick.
This is me battling with the Zaccaria experience.
Yeah. So, you get this floating menu in front of you. Now, Jared was... His experience is different than my experience, because mine, that menu is locked, and wherever you move your head, that menu is. And the problem is, because it's so close to your face, things up in the corners, you can't see. I'm looking, I'm moving my eyeballs, trying to see it. The only way I could literally get a clear vision was to tilt my head back, because then my eyeball drops, and then I was able to see. Guess what's up in that corner, folks? The play button.
So this is me, right? This is I'll give you a demonstration of what that video looks like when I'm actually doing it. This is me. So this controller it controls the menu, right? So this is the thing that you can position your menu anywhere that this controller is. And then here's me going like, "Oh." and like I'm trying to line up the laser pointer to the menu. I'm going, it's like I'm trying to shoot an arrow. Like it really is the strangest experience to use it. Like,
see, fortunately for me with using my controller, it was just joystick flicks. So again, it was just like using, because my PinSim controller essentially is a 360 controller. That's what the PinSim board replicates, is what would happen on a 360 controller. So I was navigating just like I'm used to navigating within.
Yeah.
But it was just a matter of seeing what box I'm trying to highlight to, you know, to get it into the place. Whereas Jared's was more of a VR-y experience. All right, let's keep on watching and see the wonky.
All right, so what I'm doing is I'm going into the VR menu here, and I'm trying to select my play position.
Oh, look at that clipping. Oh, my goodness.
I kind of went a little bit too low there, so I'm going to try and, like... And
oh,
again,
no, now he's in the ceiling fan.
I'm having to like literally go up like this to try and get the little laser who is actually hitting the cabinet and stopping at the cabinet that I'm clipping through. I have to go above the cabinet so I can get the laser to go into the menu. So it's no bueno.
I want you guys to remember this particular view of the cabinet. Just keep that in mind. I'm going to get to the reason why I want you to remember that in a little bit, but just keep that view in mind, being way above the cab. All right, let's keep on rolling this, see if there's more.
So here I am going, I have to like try and get this thing back down to a normal view level.
Right. Okay, so, because what Jared's doing is, whereas what Stern and Zen do, if you want to reposition the table and where you're standing in relation to the table, you push the X button and it snaps the camera to you. Zaccaria didn't do that. There is no way of snapping the camera to you. They have instead what Jared was doing there, which was a room scale slider. Yeah. And it's a slider that is at preset positions. So it'll go chick, 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 you know, depending on how you are. So in my case, where I have the sensor is exceedingly important. Because if I don't have that sensor exactly lined up at eye height, it sent me up to the roof, like what I was asking you to remember where I was playing. And then I had to go into the room scale thing and try and bring it back down to where I should be standing. And I could not get it to be a comfortable position unless, again, I threw that sensor right in front of my face.
I reckon they must have had... They must have had it set up like that when they were sitting at the VR experience in the studio. Magic Pixel must have had everything set up the way that they could in the studio, and then that was the default. So it's almost like they need to throw in instructions saying, right, so your sensors need to be 1.5 meters off the ground, and they need to be positioned at 45 degree angles from each other. And if you do that, you'll have a great time in VR. Otherwise, get wrecked, because right. It's going to be, everything's out, because that's not how we set it up.
Now, before you think, okay, so, you know, Zaccaria had a problem with that. Farsight, similar. Because when I first started, I had my sensor set off about 30 degrees off in front of me. When I go into the Stern VR app, guess where my table is? 30 degrees over. Could I reposition? No, I could not. The most I could do is reposition the table a little bit, but I could not swing it all the way around at all. So I'm like, okay, fine. So again, I put the sensor directly in front of me. Well, then it was every single time, and I'm talking every single time I loaded in a table, the height was wrong. Even though I've programmed how tall I am, Oculus should be doing the math on this.
Yep.
So even though I programmed how tall I am, it still had me being short. So how do I do that? So now I have to squat and shift over, because it also was always off center, shift over, hit the X button, and that would center the table to more or less where I wanted it to be. But because of, and Jared's is different than my experience on this, it would snap to positions.
Yes.
And so it would snap into a position, and I was fighting back and forth until eventually I just went fine, and I lifted up my controller and plopped it where I should be. Because the beautiful thing with VR is I could actually make it so that the play field felt and looked like it was at the exact same height as where my hands were actually sitting on my pin cab. And so through the bottom of the headset, you can actually see a little bit of daylight, the real world. And sometimes I'd kind of look down and I could see my hand superimposed basically over where the VR play field was, and it was perfect. That's it should be. And so once you get it dialed in, it's like, ooh, that's magic. But every single time
I loaded it on
Stern VR, I had basically, I was very aware of the fact that I'm in VR and I'm playing a program and I had to monkey around in order to get this thing to do what I wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just very disappointing, because
it really is.
Guess what? When I loaded in Zen, it just worked. It was. It didn't matter where I had the sensor. I could have the sensor low. I could have the sensor high. I could have the sensor off to the side. Boom. It always put the table smack dab right in front of me. And I would at most have to do a slight shift and realign, and that would be it. And then it would remember that position so that every other table that I loaded in
would load in that same position.
Yep. Exactly where I wanted it to be. So.
And these little things, these are the things that make a VR experience believable.
Believable and more enjoyable to stay in for a longer period
Like
of time.
You want to be in there for longer. I was in when I was like playing some of the other games, like Zaccaria and Stern. I wanted out after an hour. Like, it was just a little bit. It just felt a little bit hard.
Right.
But in FX2, I played it until my headset told me I needed to plug it back into power.
Yeah.
Like, and I went, oh, so it's been 2 and a bit hours. Okay. Sure. didn't even realize. And, you know, it's because it is just, it's very different to the other two apps in the way it immerses you and brings you in.
All right, let's look real quickly at what the menu. Oh, hold on. I'm going to show. So when you, there's a little bit of animation that happens in the Stern VR app when you select your table. And of course, as soon as I select over to here, it disappears.
Yeah.
I don't know if I have the animation caught at this particular moment.
It's very close.
Yeah. So you go ahead and you select your table, and then all of a sudden, these mechanical arms come down out of the roof, and it pulls it up. And
takes the legs off. The backboard goes off. It sucks it back in the ceiling.
Right. It brings down the new table with the, changes the art in the room. And you're like, hey, that's pretty cool. That's pretty awesome. Hey, that's great. Except for the fact that it does that every single time you pick the table.
And every you can't.
It doesn't matter if you already had that table that you played. If you went out to the main menu and then you decided to go play that table again, it will play that same animation again.
It's like it's part of the boot up process. It does that while the table is loading or something. It looks cool for the first two times. Then you go, I wish there was a skip button.
Here is what the menu on that you're greeted with for, I'm going to pause it right there, that you're greeted with for Stern VR. So, yay, you've got your high scores on the one side. You've got your table goals on the left side. You've got your options and extras and, you know, all these menus that you're greeted with. Again, you're never allowed to just melt into the VR experience. It always pummels you with the fact that you are in a game and in a fake environment, and it shifts you out of that reality. So that's kind of a bit yuck.
That's in both Zaccaria and in Stern VR. Like, you're very aware that you're playing a game.
Yeah.
You're not really playing what they, you know, like they like to call an experience.
Yeah.
In VR.